And the challenge this year was, we gave a lot of Four Pinocchio ratings. For the first time, the fact checker labeled something a lie. And that lie was the president's denial that he had any knowledge of the payments, the hush money payments that were made to women before the 2016 election.
So is the lie the biggest Pinocchio of the year?
It's at the top of the list, for whatever that's worth. It seemed that that was the appropriate place to put it. And of course, we had we have a number of other statements by the president.
There's no Russia. It was all made up by the Democrats.
Well, particularly on immigration, he has this arsenal of different falsehoods.
Right, and another thing that the president does is that he grabs on claims that really have no factual basis for anything.
I will tell you, I've had the head of U.S. Steel call me the other day, and he said, we're opening up six major facilities.
After the assassination of our former colleague, Jamal Khashoggi, the president really doubled down, tripled down on the idea that he had scored huge business deals in Saudi Arabia.
$450 billion worth of things ordered from a very rich country, Saudi Arabia.
So how many slots on the Pinocchios of the Year are designated to President Trump this year? And is that typical? Is that something we've seen before?
Well, last year he got five of the slots. And so this year we have one, two, three, four, five slots, plus one of his ads. So it's six of the total of 13.
So what else could you guys not let go of that got four Pinocchios this year?
We wrote and signed the joint letter to all 67 county supervisor elections to tell them that the Russians are in Florida's records.
You know, there's this huge controversy over adding the citizenship question to the census. So all these emails show that Ross told the Justice Department to ask him for the question. So it was just this, this ruse that he concocted.
Bernie Sanders brought up this really old, discredited claim.
We have to end the absurdity of the gun show loophole. 40% of the guns in this country are sold without any background checks.
And we had Kamala Harris, who had seized upon this idea that Kavanaugh had sent a dog whistle to pro-life supporters. Election year, the commercials do get rather out of hand.
One of my goals as U.S. Senator will be to ditch Cocaine Mitch.
An ad by the president where he falsely accused Democrats of letting a cop killer into the country. And we had an ad where the Democrats attacked a Republican candidate who actually had voted against Obamacare repeal.
What a hypocrite. What about the underage girls who accused you, according to the FBI?
The FBI had evidence that Menendez slept with underage hookers. It's just a total, doctoring of what the FBI documents actually say.
Republican lawmakers who voted to repeal the Affordable Care Act, and they used our Pinocchios to claim that the Democrats were saying something false about their vote.